Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how to measure the blood oxygen level, or the percentage oxygen in the blood rather, using what's called a pulse oximeter. Now, pulse oximeters ultimately are devices that can be used to measure the amount of oxygen that is carried by the haemoglobin in a blood sample. So what we've got here is a picture of a red blood cell, first of all, to begin with. Now, the red blood cell contains this chemical called haemoglobin, and haemoglobin combines with oxygen. And you can actually write a chemical word equation for this. Haemoglobin plus oxygen, so haemoglobin, the pigment inside the red blood cell, actually forms something called oxyhaemoglobin. Now, oxyhaemoglobin has a particular distinctive colour. It looks sort of this colour, very rich red. Now, this rich red colour that you see of the blood is when there is a lot of oxygen in it. So an oxygen-rich haemoglobin supply is bright red. So bright red is when the blood is oxygen-rich. But what we find is that that reddish colour actually becomes a sort of darker purple when we give up that oxygen and it becomes deoxygenated. So it goes slightly purpley when the blood is oxygen depleted. Now, old textbooks sort of convey the misconception that blood is red when it's got oxygen in it and blue when it doesn't, when it's deoxygenated. That's not the case. Blood is only ever shades of red, but you can see it's slightly more purple when it's oxygen depleted, or when we have deoxygenated blood. So haemoglobin is carrying oxygen around the body to tissues, ultimately to the cells for respiration. And when the oxygen is released from the haemoglobin to the cells for respiration, that's when the red blood cells ultimately have to travel back in the blood to the heart to get pumped to the lungs to go and pick up more oxygen. Now, what we can do is measure the actual level of oxygen in the blood using this information, and we use what's called a pulse oximeter. So let's imagine we've got, let's just draw a finger here, and there's the fingernail there. So there's a finger of a patient. So this is the patient's finger, and what we're going to do is measure that patient's percentage oxygen level. So I've got the patient with their finger there, and you might have seen this kind of machine that they put the finger in. It looks a bit like, it's just a very rough sketch here. You may see them in hospitals, little sort of clips that go over the finger. Now, these clips here, these are what are called pulse oximeters. So this whole device is known as the pulse oximeter, and it has two distinctive regions to it. There is a section at the top where we have emitters. So I'll just shade these regions in here. These are emitters, and these emit beams of red light. So you get a beam of red, but it's also infrared light that's emitted too. So a beam of red and infrared light from two emitters. And this whole region you can really call a transmitter. So that region, ultimately, here, is the transmitter in this device. So that part there is the transmitter. We've got beams of red or infrared light from these two emitters that make up that transmitter. Now, on the other side, so on this region here, just shade in blue, this region, what we've got is something known as a detector. So this part that I've shaded in blue is known as the detector. Now that photodetector is ultimately going to measure our light. Now when you were to, if you were to shine light on this surface, so let's say these emitters emit this beam of red light, anything that is able to, or anything that is red rather, would absorb that light, and anything that isn't red would be reflected. It's the same as, say, for example, if you look at the picture of the red blood cell that we've got in the top left, it appears right now to you red, because ultimately the screen that you're watching this video on is absorbing all parts of light except red. It's red, the red component of light that's being emitted. If you were wearing a green t-shirt, it looks green, for example, to others, because it's absorbing all wavelengths of light except the green. Now, in this case, what we have is the beams of light coming from these emitters emitting a red light, passing through a sample to the detector, and ultimately, if you have red blood, it's going to absorb that light, or that wavelength of light, the red wavelength of light that you're aiming at the detector. So what we have are the emitters and the detector, and they're placed either side of a part of the body, such as a finger, as we've seen, and the beams of light pass through the tissue. Now, some of that light is absorbed by the blood. So that's the key thing here, that some of the light is absorbed by the blood. That's the key principle behind this. Now, the amount of light absorption you get depends on the colour of the blood. So it clearly depends on, at the top here, the amount of oxyhemoglobin. So healthy individuals have usually about 95% oxyhemoglobin travelling through their arteries, delivering oxygen to the respiring cells. So a healthy level, we'll put at the top here, is about 95% oxyhemoglobin. Now, there is something called reflection pulse oximetry, which is pretty much identical to the whole setup that I've explained in this video, but the only difference is that the light is reflected off the red blood cells instead. You can still measure the percentage oxygen level in the blood, it's just it's reflecting the light off the red blood cell instead, and it's called reflection pulse oximetry. So what you'll have is this pulse oximeter, this device attached to the finger, emits the beams of light, detector will pick it up, and the redder, so the more oxygen rich the blood is, so if it's more oxygen rich, we have more oxyhemoglobin. The more oxyhemoglobin got, the more light or red light that is absorbed, and we're looking for ideally a 95% oxyhemoglobin content. Clearly, if it wasn't so red, if it was a bit more purpley, as we get when the blood is oxygen depleted or deoxygenated, that 95 value comes down. And we can tell that because attached to this detector, you'd have wires running ultimately to some kind of, just put here for completeness sake, some kind of display. So you'll read the value there and you're looking for this 95% figure. So you just read off the display whatever number it is. And there you have, that is how you measure blood oxygen levels using a pulse oximeter. You just look for the amount of light that gets absorbed by red oxygen-rich hemoglobin. Okay, hope all that helps.